scary looking bugger, isn't it? Dear me, this thing looks like Blade Runner or the Terminator. Dang it! This is a photocopier. Ah! Oh, haven't photocopiers changed? Scary buggers. Yes, be afraid. Be very, very afraid. But don't be paranoid. Just be cautious. These machines do have a nasty secret, but I love to expound the positive sides as well as the negatives. But these things do have hard drives, and they can rip you off faster than anyone can say, "Cooey!" Yeah, Australian term. Okay. We're just going to explore mainly the positive side of photocopying, but please expect me to have to be rating these machines quite aggressively at the same time. I like to keep a balanced view. So we're just going to get into this machine. I don't know how much I'm going to talk about the negative side of this thing because I don't have a scripted life. Every day is different. I've got a lot of work to do trying to get toner heads and geeks to be inspired. And this is my method of doing it because we're going to build a self-guided photocopier. And we're going to basically do it because we've got an opportunity. Konica Minolta is looking pretty shabby on the stock market. And, you know, all companies are looking pretty shabby. People hate photocopiers. This one really scares the bazookas out of people. Normal people wouldn't even approach it. I have rarely, if anyone seen approaching this thing. It's so intimidating to look at. Now, I find it as a photocopier nerd an absolute... Yes, it's very sexy, but man, does anyone have that necophiliac drive towards equipment? Normal people, the main consumer of copiers? No, I think not. So there's very few mechaphiles or geeks in this world appreciating these things. I think these things are very unpopular amongst the geeks. That's how bad they are designed. But hey, we've got to basically expound something good out of them. Now we're going to stay away from this for this first thing. Now we're going to get in here and we're just going to mess around with the color balance. Okay, let's see if we can do something a little bit more, sophisticated, or maybe we'll just keep it pretty much standard here. I think we're going to drop our sign out a bit. We'll see why. So it's a bit confusing because I'm planning on reversing the colours, so I've got to try and do a negative colour balance or a reverse colour balance. So we'll just see how it goes. It's pretty hit and miss even for a goon like me. I'm only just calling myself a goon just for the fun of it. But I don't want to call everyone else a goon because, you know, they don't like it, okay? But that's what I like to call myself. That's what I like, just for fun, you know? I've got a warped sense of humour. Yes, warped. I warp images on photocopiers. Yes, I do. I don't know if in this demo I'll be warping myself on this copier, but in this case, but done it lots of times. So we're going to take out this one, this rat bag. Yes, I can be a bit of a rat bag. Tell you what, many unemployed photocopier professionals and geeks are a lot more rat bag than I am when it comes to being insulted by being forced to work in Burger King shop type places. I'll just call it rabble. Just could call us rabble. We are often referred to as rabble, or not referred specifically, but you know, we're all rabble. Really, normal people are like rabble in a lot of ways too. They need help. They need a new copier system. Now I've got something here. Before I think I've got it. Yes, I've got to turn that off before we attempt to set up something else. So we've got to get into stamp comp. And first, we have to disable that feature first because it will clash. It's very strange. So now we're just going to go and we're going to take it off that. Oh yes, I forgot to mention in the previous demo, look at this message. This might be a R&D person having a bit of fun. Sounds like sentient machine wish, doesn't it? Okay, I better be onto it. I'll end up auto clearing. That would be terrible. So we're going to go here, but yeah, some person in the R&D lab, I believe, might be rebelling against the corporate structure of being forced to design on a tight budget plus time frame, and the Japanese people, and they really are great, the Japanese, have a lot of respect for them. But everyone, every nationality is important. So basically, I'm just going to go back in here again. But yeah, you know, something I wanted to do as a child was to love every nation as well as everybody. And that's what I'm starting to live out the dream. It's not perfect yet, but I'm on my way, because the photocopier factory has to be of all colours, right? Because a lot of people are just so racist, they're afraid. And the language barriers can be difficult too. Sorry, I forgot to set something else. It's called reduction. This machine, I'm hoping, will basically rotate the image automatically. It happened before, another demo. But it doesn't always work. So it's hard to know when to preempt the auto function and set it up manually or go auto. It's ridiculous. And as I said, I'll criticise every copier on the planet. They are pathetic, but they're still fun. Haha. And yes, I'm going to do another one of these. Right, so we're just going to take... I've decided to rename it Rat Bag again. I love that word. I just love saying that word as a kid. Rat Bag! Rat Bag! Yeah, Dad thinks I'm a rat bag. He doesn't use that term. He might have used it when I was young, but he hates me. He thinks I'm a failure. Don't want to be a failure, I'll be a success and I'll help mankind. Self-guided photocopier. Again, I've just forgotten something. So we have forgotten to set this last function, right? I don't know if we'll bother with the we'll just reset it if we lose it. Okay, this is where copier configuration art can really get amusing, really silly. Alright, but you gotta have fun, guys. This is how the photocopy industry should run. So I gotta put my face down on this silly thing, right? Silly thing. Right, remember this is overlay function. This should be a really interesting effect. Let's bump the dot feeder again. Right, then we're gonna put ourselves down on the platen. Now, it's gonna be awkward, part of the fun again. But it's good to have someone to press the button. That would be an advantage. Yes, I've got the man who'd love to do that for me. Yeah, that man's name is Luigi Benedict. Huge expert on photocopier design. But he doesn't have the opportunity to. Well, design. Oh dear, I thought it was going to output. It was going to copy again, but no. See, I'm not a good multitasker. Talking and photocopying, but this could simulate... The heavy configuration work I'm doing could simulate a normal person's 100 IQ brain average, and the talking could represent office stress. I'm not a good multitasker, but I've got the advantage here. But this, yeah, didn't rotate, but it's still a good image, see? Yeah, unfortunately the world, a lot of normal people appear to be two-faced in their attitudes. Very tragic. So yeah, we just demonstrated that auto-rotate just didn't... It's off. Okay. Now it's off. And see, it says off. Now it says off when I light up the button. But see, you can't rely. You don't... There's certain parameters that determine... And I, even as a nerd, can't even determine it. So why should a normal person be thinking like me? No, no, no. Okay, we'll try a different tack. I wanted to do a movement image, but we can... What can I say? I can't use the bypass tray because it's right in the way, but then these machines are not usually expected to be used this way. Okay, we're going to do something different. We're going to open up the bypass. We're going to do another bypass feed. We're going to try a different way of working. We're going to use the reduction, right? Now, or maybe not. I've decided not. Yeah, I think we'll stick with it. I'm not a good decision maker, right? Every day is different, right? I feel I've got something that helps me do photocopier art and copier configure really well. I call it the X factor. Something few people like to think about or even know about and make their lives easier and happier and give them peace and make them successful. But then success is also a team effort too. So sometimes the X factor in certain groups of people can only give people success when they work as a team. But basically, yeah, sometimes I feel when I do something wrong, things don't work out right if I do it. But it's all for the better. It's all for my good. I lost my settings, damn it. Auto clear. Yeah, I've got to try and be careful to lock the hard drive on this while I'm chatting away. But you get my drift. But basically, we've got most of the settings in mode memory now, which shows how important this feature is when you need to. This is good in a public sitch. It's also good when you're a printer, when you have to do the same job again. You want consistent results and less waste. So we're just going to open up Ratbag. This might be a case for taking trouble for a regular customer. Now, why am I deleting this? Sorry, multitasking. So basically, we're just going to open up Ratbag. We're opening Ratbag. Opening, not deleting it. Right, we don't want this old functions that were there. And all we have, yes, I actually, did I put that in? I don't remember putting that in. Is it slider activity? Weird things happen to equipment. Ha ha ha. Weird. Okay, one thing we haven't done is we haven't set up the bypass tray. Okay, it's a little bit, so yeah. I think I did put paper in on camera, I don't remember. Yes, I did. Absent-minded BizHub professor, short-term memory problems. Yes, makes it hard to multitask even more. Okay, so the tray settings I think was pretty well set up. Got to know a bit about this, it's a bit of a pain. Again, it's easy to get these wrong. It's hard to know exactly what happened to the copier, you know. Also, just got to check something. Yes, we've got that mode for better quality. Okay, it looks like we're all set. All we have to do now, do we have to really do this for the bypass? I'm just going to do it just in case. Then it'll be an instant recovery. But there'll always be a problem with manually setting this up at first. But we haven't got a self-guided or a sentient photocopier yet. We haven't got a machine that'll work itself like this. So you can imagine my human brain, right, which is very adapted, is ideally adapted to this. Being sampled onto a silicon chip one day, and the more I play this machine in a lab, in a photocopier lab, the better I become, and then this kind of behavior becomes the basis of a self-guided photocopier, sentient photocopier. There you go. Yes, but before we can build a sentient photocopier, we're just going to have fun with this rubbish that we have today. Now, I don't know which way to roll my head, but this is really, I'll just slide it. It's sliding, slider, get it? This is a different form of slider. More familiar. Okay, that's the first scan. Okay, then I'm going to put our head down and scan it again. Okay, this is the sliding. Okay, that's the second one. Timed output after this. Okay, finish, start, and the output should come very soon. That image is really good. So it's going to take a little bit of extra time. That was the bypass tray, making that clunk noise. I love that sound because Konica Minolta's hardware, compared with, say, Xerox, is really rugged. I love this heavy ruggedness. Of course, I still give this machine 2 out of 100. My machine will have to be 98 out of 100. High standard. Now, I've done a mistake. Damn it. See? Error. Human error. Okay, let's just diagnose what I've done wrong. Yes, see? Human error. Manual setup. Okay, you'll have to, yeah. So that would be, that's a pain, right? Also, we're meant to have negative image, not positive image in this case. But we don't want our attitudes to be negative because we've faced the industry and the industry doesn't want our input anymore. You know, I used to work in the photocopy industry, so it shows that the culture has changed and they won't even let people in. I'm disabled. I've got one of the problems I have with my brain, as well as Asperger's syndrome, which is Asperger's not the problem. I've got short-term memory problems. That's just one of the problems I have. Working memory. I'm also stereo blind, which means I only see in 2D, which means I make a lot of visual errors. So the thing is, there's no excuse for other Aspies, therefore, not to go in. So I had to leave the photocopier industry gracefully, but others are not so happy about it. Very miserable. This is my therapy. This is my life for now. Lots of fun. Okay, we're going to try it again from a different angle now. At least when I make a mistake,
It means you see more entertainment, right? Funniness, hilarity, photocopy, comedy. Not easy to do this one camera, but anyway, that's enough for now. Time for output. Start button. There you go. Wait for the output. Coming. There goes the bypass again. Not many of you biz hub people, not, you know, amateur biz hub people I'm mainly pitching this at, would be familiar with the front of the bypass tray. Beautiful sound compared to the equipment of today, other equipment. There you have it, that's a double image. Very nice. Okay, we're going to add some more to this image. We'll show you how. Okay, so how we're going to do it. Now, I don't know if I'll be altering. Well, we're going to turn off the stamp comp. Right, we don't want it now. Right. So basically now we're just going to switch it off. That's it, we're going to close it. And now we're just going to go. We're going to add some more effects and adjustments. So background color. What color will we like? I think red goes well with this profile. And also we're going to take off Neggy Posse, right? And also we're going to basically now add something to it. Now I feel like I'm drawn towards blue, but basically now we're going to see what we do with this
white one.
So I'm just going to add a little bit of blue, see what it does. But basically now magenta's at full range. Just wondering if I should add back the black. So if we should full range all the colours, or whether we should leave it. Right, so just going to full range the colours. I think we're going to do that. Black would be, it'd be nice to get back. Well, black, we need black, I'm wondering. Trying to work out intuitively if I should just simply hit that OK button. Yeah, we'll just keep it there, right? Just going to keep it that way. We don't get too regular about it. Okay. Okay, photocopier industry. You've got to have a bit of fun, right? So, original settings dropped out again. We're going to have to set it for A5 size. Because this is A5 you just looked at. A5R, so that's A5, half of A4. Metric system. Okay, sorry about the guys who don't work on this metric system. Right. Okay, we're not going to bother saving it into the mode. We're just going to get straight on the platen. Oh, one thing I forgot. Oh dear, human error again. We want to enlarge. So again, this is a hard area to learn about photocopiers, to interpret. This will be very challenging when designing a self-guided photocopier. It may mean that the operator has their brain hooked up to this machine or some kind of hookup. We can't work this out now, but that's going to be a challenge. Okay, I'll just straighten it up a bit. Close dock feeder. Now we're just going to output. See how it goes. Okay, so waiting for the output to come, there goes the bypass. Now, why am I saying that? You copier people probably know more about this stuff than I do, but I just do that. People have been told, accused me, including my mother, oh, you go into too much detail. Asperger's syndrome, and I've always been grilled for that in suburbia. It'll be good in maybe in a lecture on copier design, but not so good out here. There you go. Okay, I've decided to save that lovely profile to mode memory. So we're just going to save it in HA. Okay, yes, photocopy industry's got to have a more party-like attitude. Yes, mini button, yeah, HA, like programmer fun. Programmer, yep. Lots of fun, eh? HA! Techno, rave, whatever you're into. Doesn't have to always be techno. We're all different. Many of us love techno. Okay, with this profile, we're now going to take off this one, and we're going to add another one. So yeah, we're going to put this on the platen. Right, I'll put this on the machine's platen. Now I had to delete a scene because I bogged the hard drive midway through and I had to delete off this phone. I talk too much. Aha, yes, not so good. So now we lost our settings. This is what the mode memory is good for, so we'll probably have to pull up on this demo. It's costing me a lot of money, money I don't have, but you know, if you love something, you care about it, you're willing to sink your last dollar into it. The man who invented the original photocopier, Chester F. Carlson of Xerox fame, founder of Xerox, he was willing to put his life on it. He had nothing, no friends, no money. He was worse off than us. Now I'm hoping that I've remembered this is the one we've used.
right? So now we're just probably gonna make some more changes. We're gonna take advantage of this sitch. I already output a copy, went off camera, that you probably saw. I don't like to include those. I always wanna make sure everything's got a contingent about it. So I'm gonna take advantage of this. I'm questioning whether I should, no, I'm gonna go keep it simple. I'm gonna try a different color this time. Try to think what color would rock with this. We're gonna try a different one. Go yellow. Okay. Whether we're gonna just ram up the satch. Probably just a little bit. We're not gonna get too carried away. We might have gotten a bit carried away. We also have to use the brightness control, give it a little bit something. Now I hope I haven't gone too ape over. Watch the bypass. Yeah, that bypass tray in a public place. It's quite a weapon here. So basically I'm feeling now, we're just gonna do a second one doing that other copy. We're not gonna get too carried away here, because I feel it's a sign, you know, when that happens, you know, X Factor does this, you know. Can't talk too much. And yes, there's a sign there. That to me is a sign that this demo is gonna be pulled up, you know. Weird things happen with numbers and that, gives me a message. Now that, we won't look at that copy because it's not on camera. I like to do things to the letter. This is the yellow one. Not perfect, but still it looks good. Yeah, better fold this up before I forget. Don't want anyone to get injured or the machine, but the machine has survived a bang on this. I've witnessed it. Very strong construction, kind of a Minolta. So here's our first image. That didn't quite work out layout-wise, but it was very beautiful. The other image with the fouled up layout and configuration, that's still got a beautiful detail to it. We don't throw this stuff away. Every image is an individual. So here's the reprocessed two-face image. If I remember correctly, enlarged 141%. Yes, and here's our beautiful face roll. This is the original face roll overlay. And you have the other one, which I remember correctly, was enlarged 141%, which would be called in this A4 to A3 ratio. Now, there's something strange about them two enlargements I did. This enlargement appears to be bigger than 141%. Very odd. So I don't know if it's slider activity, which I experienced with equipment, or whether there's something funny with this machine's enlargement. I don't know what happened, but it shouldn't have gone that big on both images.